expressed on the Edge are not necessarily those of this radio station, its staff, management, or other sponsors. It's time for the Edge Radio broadcast with your host, Daniel Ott. You can join Daniel and his guest as we discover the truth together. Within the continental U.S., call toll-free 1-800-996-9638 or click on the Fast Blast link on the Edge Broadcast website. That's toll-free 1-800-996-9638 or click on the Fast Blast link on the Edge Broadcast website. You can find out more about our guests and topics by logging onto the Edge's website at theedgeam.com. That's theedgeam.com. And now, here's your host for the Edge Radio broadcast. Here's Daniel Ott.
You're on the Edge.
Yeah, hi. I'm the one that called earlier about going to that revival in Lakeland.
Yes, sir.
And when I went there with another brother in the Lord with me, and we sat there for, you know, quite through the hours of them going through the healing process. Mm-hmm. And I went and sat down, and there was a gentleman sitting next to me who was blind, and we talked to him for a while, and he said that he'd been going there for 16 days already, mm-hmm. and he still hasn't received any healing in his vision. So he was saying, I was going to stay until my healing comes. So, you know, I had a little bit of concern about a man that's been going there for over 16 days and still hadn't got healed yet. Mm-hmm. And then I saw people in wheelchairs. Now, they're still sitting in wheelchairs. So, you know, there's a certain place where faith is in action. But still, I believe in 16 days, you know, his faith, if he was a true believer, would, you know, at least gave him that sight to see. Mm-hmm. So there's just certain things that I wouldn't say for true if he's a true healer working in that faith or not. I don't know.
Yeah. So did you see any genuine miracles there yourself?
No. All I saw was just...
If you didn't see any miracles there, did they ever pass the bucket?
Oh, that was done at the end, yes, right before. Mm-hmm. Right before they had a time where he said he was going to lay hands on every single person mm-hmm. inside the room. That was his, at the end, he laid his hands on every single person before they leave and giving them a promise of faith to go out and heal.
So they passed the bucket before he started laying hands on people.
Yes, right at the end.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Okay, hey, thanks for the call. You're on the Edge.
Yes, I want to talk to Daniel.
You're talking to Daniel.
Hey, Daniel, this is Bruce from Gainesville, Georgia. How you doing tonight?
Hey, Bruce.
Hey, listen, I saw the coverage you did on Matthew Stevens a couple weeks ago.
Okay.
And I was impressed with the interview, and so I shot him a message, and I asked, when are you coming to my area, you know, the Atlanta area?
Mm-hmm.
Turned out he was going to be in Dalton, Georgia the very next day, so I drove down there to listen to the guy, and I'll tell you, I believe he's the real deal.
Really?
You know, there's a lot of people who want to, you know, say these guys are in it for money and so forth, but I'll tell you, I went out to see this guy, listened to him, mm-hmm. met him.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't ask for a dime. I had nothing to sell, took up no offering plate, and even paid for the room that night.
Wow.
And then, you know, he was there briefly and off to his next city.
Mm-hmm.
But I'll tell you, he's got me really shaken up. I've been looking at his prophecies on his website and so forth, and mm-hmm. I think this guy has pegged it right.
If you were, say, somebody on a platform and you had a message that there is some events, cataclysmic events, apocalyptic events coming, or if you said you were on the stage and you said it's time for you to get your blessing, which one do you think would command more attention and fill the buckets deeper?
Well, everybody wants to be told that, you know, they're going to be prosperous. God's going to make them a millionaire. You know, there's mm-hmm. not going to be any end to prosperity in America. Mm-hmm. So people are going to flock to that kind of message.
Mm-hmm.
And when you hear a message from a guy that says, repent for judgment's on the land, you know, very, that's not a popular message. So certainly people are going to run by the truckloads down to get their gold dust and their blessing.
Well, do you ever read the biblical text?
Read it every day.
Okay. In your reading of it, do you see an end-time outpouring of gold dust, bubbles, feathers, balloons, gold teeth, the house being paid off? Do you see that outpouring coming as written towards, say, heading through the book of Revelation, or do you see more what Matthew Stevens has been saying? Which one do you see more, if at all, of the two? Is there an outpouring blessing that is prophesied in there before anything else?
No, what I see is a warning from Jesus himself, which said, when they say, you know, go out to the desert or go into the hidden chamber, you know, they say Christ is, you know, appearing at these events, you know, don't go there. Mm-hmm. And, you know, that's basically what these guys are doing. They're saying, you know, come down here, we're going to lay hands on you. You're going to see a supernatural outpouring. Mm-hmm. And while that can happen if it's a real man of God, that's not what luring people down there. They're hoping to get their gold dust, you know,
well, isn't,
their financial blessing.
Well, doesn't that qualify? Because I am sure that even Mr. Bentley and probably most televangelists would be very quick to say, hey, I'm not healing you. Jesus is healing you through me. Therefore, by extrapolation, wouldn't they be saying Jesus will be at our event healing you?
You know, if he was the real deal, that's what you'd be hearing, but that's not what you're hearing. All the attention is being put on this individual. I have not met the guy, but from everything that I have seen, and he's not the first type to come along like this, I think what you've got is some people who are demonically possessed.
Okay.
And, you know, the Bible says don't let anybody suddenly lay hands on you. So, you know, I've heard reports of people going down there and coming out of there and being ill in mass. So, you know, a demonic spirit can be imputed into a person just by laying hands, apparently, if they're not covered by the blood of Jesus.
Hey, Bruce?
You actually run a real risk to even be present in places like that.
Okay. Hey, Bruce, let me let you go, and let me get Matthew Stephen on the line.
Thank you for your time.
All right, sir.
And bring him back on. He's a great speaker. We need that kind of message. Thank you.
He's on right now. You're on the edge.
Joe. Daniel, this is Matthew Stephen.
Matthew Stevens, it seems no matter what show I have, your name comes up.
Really?
The caller,
All right.
The caller that was just calling in, Bruce, was just talking about you. He said he went to visit you, and he says that you're the real deal.
Really?
Yes.
Well, I appreciate that.
He said
we appreciate that. Go ahead, Daniel.
Yeah, no, he said that when he seen you, you didn't pass the bucket and try to sell him a CD.
Oh, okay. So, amen. Well, that's true. I don't sell anything. I appreciate that, brother.
What's going on, Matthew?
Amen for that. Oh, just a whole bunch of stuff is happening. We're on the show now live, and I guess there's a lot happening here on this whole journey. I was wanting to let the listeners know, as well as you, I guess I'm sure you got my